You're watching We Love DevOps, a video series on testing in DevOps brought to you by Team Miracle.
Hi, this is Usha Kiranmay, working as Morpheus Research Associate in Miracle Innovation Lab. Today, I would like to speak how to manage multiple clouds using Morpheus, which is one of the cloud management tools. So let us see the concepts that I'm going to speak in this video. The very first one is cloud management tools and what are the features that are provided by Morpheus and what are the types of clouds that were supported by Morpheus and how can we make continuous integration with Morpheus by overcoming the managing of development team and operations team and what are the challenges that we are facing with the clouds nowadays in most of the organizations. So let us move on to the first slide, cloud management tools. The name itself says that it was a tool to manage the whole cloud. So before entering into the concept, let us recall the main important features of the cloud. The very first one is flexibility, which allows the developers to provision a number of VMs or the containers needed instantly. Whereas second one is cost. We know that cloud allows pay-as-you-go model. That means how many number of servers we have used and how much amount of capacity of servers we have used. For that only the charges will be applied. And the third one is services. We know that cloud provides a lot of services from provisioning an instance to deploying a code onto that particular instance. Now we will speak about that services. For instance, if your organization is only maintaining a single cloud, it's not an issue. But what about the case if your organization wants to maintain multiple clouds with different number of services provided by the multiple service providers? Isn't it so difficult? Yes. At that situation, these cloud management tools will be helpful, which helps us to achieve speed, flexibility, security, and cost efficiency. Simply, we can say that it overcomes the complexity of IT organizations. By using these cloud management tools, it was easy to purchase, build, manage, monitor, track, and optimize cloud resources. So this is the overview of the cloud management tools. So before entering into the next slide, the Morpheus is one of the cloud management tools which have the capability to handle multiple clouds on a single pane of glass. So let us see the most unique features that were supported by the Morpheus. The very first one is infrastructure. The servers, server capacity, storage capacity, everything comes under this infrastructure. So for instance, if you wanted to create a number of VMs or the containers at the spot, it's really difficult to create that many number of VMs. So by using this feature, we can create any number of VMs or the containers. And the second feature is monitoring. So once you created a VM or container, we need a team to manage those VMs or to track those. So the monitoring feature will be helpful to track those VMs and find out the errors what in those. And the next one is backups. So if we deploy an application onto this server, definitely we need a backup for that, which really avoids the disaster recovery. So by using this feature, we can achieve that. And next one is reports. The reports generate regarding the how many number of servers we have utilized and how much amount of capacity we have utilized. So it generates reports regarding that and it provides information to the users. And next one is logs. Logs is nothing but simply an error. So these logs helps us to identify the errors and helps us to rectify those errors. So by using this feature, we are able to rectify the errors and what we done through Morpheus. And last one is provisioning. Provisioning is nothing but something supplied. So this feature will be most helpful when we create an instance. So in most of the cases, we need to write a code and we need to deploy onto the cloud in order to create the instance. But in Morpheus, by using this feature, we can create the instance automatically with simple configuration details. So I will show what are the configuration details which will be most be useful in creating the instance in further slides. So let us move on to the next slide. What are the types of clouds that were supported by Morpheus? So we know that clouds are differentiated into two types, public clouds and private clouds. So these are the clouds that comes under public and these are the clouds that comes under private. So sometimes we need to use the combination of both public and the private clouds, which is known as the hybrid cloud, which is used mostly for security purposes. We will be looking into that in further slides. So previously I mentioned that if an organization wants to maintain a single cloud, it's not an issue. But what about the case if the organization wants to maintain these many number of clouds at the same time? It really needs a lot of teams to manage, what we call a lot of people to track those issues. Those can be overcome by using this Morpheus, which is one of the cloud management tools. The next slide is continuous integration with Morpheus. This is the development team, which comprises of build, code, plan, and testing. This is the operations team, which comprises of release, deploy, operate, and the monitor stages. So for development team, we need a large number of people to manage all those stages. Even for operations team, we need a large number of people to manage all the stages. But by using Morpheus, which is a cloud management tool, a single user can handle all these stages. Means a single user can build, a single user can plan, a single user can operate, can monitor, can deploy. Everything can be done by a single user, as the Morpheus have the flexibility to handle all the multiple clouds on a single pane of glass. So this is possible through a single user. We need not to maintain any large number of teams to manage all these concepts. So let us move on to the next slide. What are the challenges that we are facing with the clouds nowadays in most of the organizations? So the very first one is migration. Do you need a migration really? Sometimes we need to move on between the clouds, that may be from public to public or public to private, based upon your workloads of your organization, or maybe some dynamic characteristics that's like demand, pricing, etc. So in these cases, it's really difficult to move between the one service provider to another service provider. At this case, this Morpheus will be very helpful to move from one cloud to another cloud within a seconds of time. And the very next one is burden on operations team. In previous slide, I discussed there's a really requires a lot of team to manage multiple clouds. We are increasing the burden on the operations team. If it is a single cloud, it's not an issue. But what about the case if we wanted to maintain multiple clouds? We need to maintain multiple members to manage all those clouds. So we can reduce the burden on operations team by using the Morpheus, through which a single user can handle the whole infrastructure. And the very next one is hybrid platform, which is a combination of both public and the private clouds. In some scenarios, we need to use this hybrid platform, like in real-time scenarios, if you take the banks wants to store their employees' PIN number or account number or how much amount is stored in their account in private cloud, and they wanted to store the remaining details in public cloud. Then this hybrid platform will be most useful, which is also preferable for security purposes. Then it's not, the work can be done by using a single cloud. We need to use multiple clouds. At the time, this Morpheus will be helpful to manage those clouds on a single pane of glass. So let us move on to the next slide. In this slide, I will introduce the dashboard of Morpheus and how can we manage multiple clouds using Morpheus. We'll see. This is the dashboard of Morpheus. You can see here a number of services are there. Under this, a number of sub-services are there. So the main task is to utilize those services. That's what the reason I mentioned previously, that a single user can manage the whole infrastructure by giving a simple configuration details. So let us see. This is the provisioning, which indicates how many number of instances we have provisioned previously. And this is monitoring, which provides you the status regarding the instances you have provisioned or the work you've done through Morpheus. And these were the logs, which indicates the errors. So it will help us to view our errors and able to rectify that. And these are the backups. It will show that how many number of backups we have created, in that how many are successful and how many are failure. Let us go down. And these are the instances which I have created previously. This is the name and IP port. So this is the instances which I have created. So these are the recent activities which I have performed previously. And monitoring, it shows you the status regarding the work that done through Morpheus. And these are the logs. Currently, I don't have any logs. But if it does have, definitely it will show the logs which are indicated with red mark, So if you click on that, you can view the errors on the work you done through Morpheus, so which helps us to rectify the errors. And these are the backups, so which shows that how many number of backups you have and how many are successful and how many are failure backups. So it shows the total number of count regarding your backups. So now let us see that how can we manage multiple clouds using Morpheus. So you can see here the infrastructure, which is a service, and under this the clouds, which is one of the subservices. So just click on that. Yes. So you can see here previously we worked with many clouds like Amazon, Azure, Google, OpenStack and VMware, in which OpenStack and VMware are the private clouds and remaining all were public clouds. So we can create a cloud with different locations in Virginia and Eastern region. So we have an option to create a cloud with different locations. So if you wanted to create a cloud, just click on create cloud. Just click on the cloud you wish to create. So now I will just, you can see here a number of clouds supported by the Morpheus. Now I will go with Amazon cloud. Click on next. It will ask us to fill the configuration details. So previously we worked on that. So I will show those configuration details. Yes, the name of the cloud and code and location, in which location you wanted to create your cloud, and visibility and account. These two will be useful when you want to create access to your sub account users. That means in the drop down list of account, you can see here the Chanakya, who is the master account, and Usha Kiranmai, who is the sub account. So if you wanted to provide access to this sub account, then we will need to change the settings, visibility as private and account as Usha Kiranmai. But now I'm not going to change that and I will keep the same. And region, in which region you wanted to create your cloud. You can see here a lot more regions are there. So select one of the region in which you wanted to create the cloud, and access and the secret keys. So for every region, there will be an access and the secret keys. So please be ensure that you gave the correct, or otherwise this cloud won't work when you wanted to provision your instances or if you wanted to do anything with this. So here VPC virtual private cloud. So you can create a default VPC or you can create a separate VPC for this cloud. So I gave the default and click on save changes. Yes. So this is how a public cloud can be managed. And let us see the configuration details of the private cloud, which is OpenStack. So these details are the same, the name, code, location, visibility and account. Whereas let's see the remaining details, identity, API URL, the domain ID. So for every API URL, we have a domain ID and project, in which project you are going to work with it, and username, password, and OS version. So different OS versions are there, so you need to select one, and in which image format. So please be ensure that API URL and domain ID are were correct, because it provides authentication to the users, because the OpenStack is a private cloud. So if you gave the wrong details, the cloud won't work. And if you wanted to provision instance or that, or if you wanted to work with it. So after giving the appropriate details, click on save changes. Yes, this is how a private cloud can be managed. So using the same process, every cloud can be managed, and we can't ensure that the same configuration details for all the clouds, because every cloud service provider has different configuration details. So if you chose a cloud, they may ask you to give the fill the different configurations. So for every cloud, there will be a different configuration details. So you can see here for every separate cloud, we have a two options called edit and delete. So if you want to make changes for a particular cloud, just click on edit option and you can make changes for that cloud. And if you wanted to delete that cloud, you can delete that cloud. You can migrate to another cloud. So this is as simple as you can migrate from public to private or private to public. You can migrate between the clouds by giving a simple configuration details. This is how a multiple cloud can be managed using the Morpheus, which is a cloud management tool.
Thank you for watching our video series brought to you by Team Miracle. For more videos on testing and DevOps, please visit miraclesoft.com/welovedevops.